Very good morning to all our present here. This is Prasanna Mohan as a research scholar and associate professor from the Department of Physiotherapy, Garden City University. I'm happy to present my research paper on the first international conference on women's mental and physical health. And I thank the organizers for giving this opportunity. The title of my research work is The Effect of Kinesiotaping on Pain Pressure Thresholds in Work-Related Low Back Pain for Computer Professionals. Work-Related Musculoskeletal Disorders are the class of musculoskeletal disorder that includes damage of tendons, tendon sheath, synovial lubrications of tendon sheath and related to bones, muscles and nerves of the hands, wrist, elbow, shoulders, neck and back. So in our study, there is musculoskeletal pain which is causing due to the prolonged sitting by the computer users in IT professionals were having a prominent involvement in the lower back regions. Most of the computer users may have the problems with the neck, shoulders, elbow, wrist, upper back and lower back. These were the issues they are facing. In this study, we are trying to identify the effect of kinesiotape on the pain pressure threshold in various locations of the lower back region. When there is a survey which is conducted on the prevalence of work-related musculoskeletal disorder in IT professionals, the majority of the injuries happens to the neck, which occupies almost 30%, followed by the lower back pain is very common. So why do the people who are working in the systems are developing such kind of injuries is mainly the acquired posture which they are adopting when they are doing the job, particularly in terms of sustained posture in sitting and the abnormalities. And also they do a repeated task on a desk job using the mouse and keyboards. And also there's a lot of contact just happens to the wrist and forearm as well as for the lower back, which is leading to the injuries to various aspects, particularly in case of neck, shoulders, and then elbow and upper and lower backs. So today's my topic, which is the particularly non-specific low back pain, which is developing due to the prolonged sitting job. The aim of the study is to determine the effect of kinesiotaping compared with effect of rigid taping along with tens and back access program on work-related low back pain in computer professionals. So the main objective is that for today's scientific presentation and then research work which I have done is on the pain pressure thresholds. So there are various points in the lower back, particularly lumbar sacral regions, the non-specific low back pain which patient exhibit tenderness. So this can be measured by using a objective scale, which is a ergometer. So what I have done is that taken multiple trigger points or the tender points, which is present in the lower back, and then analyzed for the two different groups and find out the effect of the kinesiotape as well as rigid tape. The hypothesis, there is no significant difference between kinesiotaping and rigid taping along with the tens and back access program in computer professionals with work-related low back pain. And in contrast, the alternative hypothesis is there may be a significant difference between kinesiotaping and rigid taping along with tens and back access in computer professionals with work-related low back pain. So the outcome measures which is taken for this study is pressure algometers. This is an analog algometers which will be able to identify the tender points with the objective measures. So I have taken a measurements of the pain pressure threshold in seven locations, that is between the intraspinous process, which is five locations, and then the quadratus lumborum, either right or left side. So these measurements, which is being taken by three repeat attempts and then average of the outcome, which is being considered to be a pain pressure threshold for a particular point. The study design is a randomized single blinded experimental study design, and then the data collections happened last 13 months, and the study location was the outpatient department of Ghana City University affiliated hospitals. Inclusion criteria for this study was that chronic non-specific low back pain for 3 or more months, which is a mandatory requirement, and any age between 18 to 50 years, which are included. No radiation pain of low back pain, which is excluded in the study. And also normal neurological findings of lumbar nerves, including deep tendon reflexes, plantar responses. And also computer professionals with more than 3 years working experience. Those who are working in front of computers for 40 hours or more in a week. And also professionals work in a day and night shifts also included. The exclusion criteria, which is particularly to the all pathological conditions, because the study is based upon the non-specific low back pain, and the diagnosis with the IVDP, any structural deformities in spinal cord, recent back surgeries, any pathological or spinal conditions, fibromyalgia, clinical signs of radiculopathy, spondylolisthesis, previous treatment with kinesiotape or rigid tape, and peripheral nervous system disease, subjects undergoing regular core exercise program, subject with frequent traveling, and persons allergic with kinesiotape or rigid tape. This is a model of study design where 196 subjects were screened and found eligible. Out of that, there are 84 subjects were excluded because there are 66 subjects not meeting the inclusion criteria, and then 13 declined to participate, and 5 other people, which is for different reasons, they did not participate in the study. So totally we have arrived to 112 subjects which is used and divided into 2 groups. One is group A, which is gone for the kinesiotape groups, and group B is the rigid tape groupings, equally divided into 56-56 for both groups. And at the end of the study, there are 4 dropouts in kinesiotape groups, and then there are 3 dropouts in rigid tape groups. And the pain pressure thresholds are measured in the 7 locations. They are compared between the groups by the comparison. So the 112 samples were divided into 2 groups, such as experimental group A, kinesiotaping, and group B, rigid taping group interventions. All subjects were screened for non-specific mechanical low back pain caused due to work-related musculoskeletal disorder. And all the subjects were evaluated by pain pressure threshold by the ergometer. This slide shows that method of applications of kinesiotape for lower back pain. And there are 2 vertical strips, ice strips are used to align these muscles of iliocostalis or erector spine. And then there's a horizontal strip which is applied to the maximal pain region, which includes intraspinous or the quadratus lumborum region. And this is a method of application of rigid tape. This non-elastic tape which is applied to the lumbar sacral region, where 2 anchoring strips, which is in the horizontal top and bottom, and then 2 vertical strips laterally applied. And there's a 1X formed between the anchoring strips, which is exactly making the X into the region of L2, L3. That mainly gives support to the lower back region. And these are 10 supplication procedures where we used 10 heads, 100 milliseconds duration for 30 minutes applications is being given. And various exercise protocol mainly concerned over about the core stability exercises, which is taught to the patients to repeat for 10 to 20 times twice daily for 2 weeks program. It's mainly about the supine abdominal draw in in the double V chest. A supine twist, prone bridging on elbows, side bridging on elbows, and quadruped positions of arm and leg rise, and supine butt lift with arm at side. So all the exercise being taught to the patients. So now after these intervention programs for 2 weeks, for 3 sessions a week, after before and after, the data which is collected by pain pressure threshold, which was analyzed by using statistical software SPSS-20. By doing the ANOVA. And the result which is collected from various pain pressure thresholds are presented here. We paint the threshold between L1 L2, the mean comparison results, which found that there was a significant difference in kinesiotype group as well as ergotype groups when it compared individually or between groups. That indicate that kinesiotype groups was better in improving pain pressure threshold in L1, L2 level. Similarly, the pain pressure threshold between L2 and L3 were compared within and between groups. The KT group and rigid groups showed this significant difference in the pre-post comparisons, but when both groups are compared, no group was considered to be better because the significant level was 0.152. And the pain pressure threshold in L3, L4 level, which showed by the statistical analysis that both groups showed a significant improvement, and also when it is compared, that kinesiotype groups was comparatively better than the rigid tape group. The pain pressure threshold for L4, L5 level, when both were compared for the mean difference by ANOVA, the groups individually, KT or rigid tape groups, which showed statistical significant difference, and also when both groups were compared, the kinesiotype group was better, significantly different, the p value was 0.34. Similarly, when the interspinous region L5-S1 for PPT was compared between groups and within groups, both sorts showed that statistical significant difference, which indicates that kinesiotype group was better in the improving pain pressure threshold in L5-S1 region. Then come to the pain pressure threshold on quadratus lumborum, whereas when both were compared within group and between groups, it says that there is significant difference in KT group as well as rigid tape groups when it is compared pre-post test comparisons. And also when both group are compared, the p-value is 0.008, which indicates that kinesiotape group was better in improving the pain pressure threshold in quadratus lumborum right side. Similarly, when the quadratus lumborum left side pain pressure threshold was compared, that there was significant difference within the group, but there was a very marginal significance which is found 0.078, which indicates there is no group is better. So based upon the results which is presented earlier, the kinesiotype groups were showing better in almost all the pain pressure threshold in terms of improving the pain sensitivity. Unlike numerical rating scales, pain pressure threshold was best evaluated objectively by the dolorimeter, and there are certain pain points subject with the chronic low back pain always having a pain sensitivity, particularly interspinous process between L1 to S1 and also quadratus lumborum. So this study, which found that by taking multiple pain pressure thresholds and which is compared before and after within group and between groups, which found that a statistical significant difference by giving a superiority of kinesiotape than the rigid tape. But when compared between groups except L2, L3 and quadratus lumborum left side, all others showed kinesiotape group was better in managing pressure threshold, was statistically significant, which is p was lesser than 0.005. So mechanically L2, L3 is a least bearing stress in lumbar curvature as line of gravity goes closer to the joint, since the effect of kinesiotape did not show better result when compared with rigid tape. The taping along with the pain applications produces neurotransmitters like gamma aminobutyric acid, which are also involved in inhibition of nociceptive traffic, thus reducing muscle soreness. And also the kinesiotape believed to reduce paravertebral muscle fatigue, so it may be assumed to reduce musculoskeletal injury in computer professionals and also facilitate the applications provide adequate anticipatory postural control in back muscles to maintain the correct postures during the working hours. So after concluding doing the research work, I would like to conclude that group A treated by kinesiotape, transcutaneous electrical nerve stimulations and core stability exercises improved in pain pressure thresholds and disability with high statistical significance, which is p is equal to or less than 0.05. Similarly, Group B was featured by Rutubtec also showing the much improvement when it is individually compared to the significant level is equal to or less than 0.05. But Kinesiotape compared with Rutubtec, whereas strengths and co-stability excesses were common protocol, the result found that Kinesiotape is better than Rutubtec in all parameters with a significant of p is 0.05 except quadratus lumborum left and L2 L3 level. PPT measures with a significant of p is equal to 0.78 and p is equal to 0.152 respectively. And so this study is concluded Kinesiotape intervention was better than rigid tape technique, thus null hypothesis rejected and alternative hypothesis accepted. These are the references which I used, and thank you very much for patience listening, and I thank the organizers for giving the opportunity. Thank you very much.